Today, our heroes along with their new friend Cat, are going to be going to Mount Moon, looking for a Clefairy. What adventures will today hold? Let's find out. I can see Mount Moon. Oh, I can see it too. I'm so excited. So, Cat, do you live in Pewter City? Yeah. My dad works in Cerulean and he goes through Mount Moon every day to go to work. Are you taking part in the gym challenge too? No, I plan on it one day though. My dream is to become Kanto's first fairy type gym leader. Really? I think you could do it. Do you mean that? Of course I do. Yeah, you seem like you'd be a great gym leader. Thanks guys. Pika. Squirtle. Pikachu and Squirtle both called as the mouth of Mount Moon became visible. There it is guys. Come on. Reese, Angel, Cat, Maroon, Pikachu, Squirtle, Charmander, Bulbasaur, and Jigglypuff ran into the cave that is Mount Moon. Whoa. It's so cool in here. It's a lot bigger in here than I thought it'd be. Let's start looking. Right. The four with their Pokemon started to search around for a Clefairy. Angel found and caught a Paris, Maroon caught a Geodude, and Reese caught a Zubat. Outside, the trio had caught an Ekans and Sandshrew. We're filling in the pages, guys. Pikachu and Squirtle cheered. Hey. Reese turned to see a lass. Ya wanna battle? I guess I could. I've also wanted to try using Dratini in a real battle. Sure, why not? Cool. The two found a suitable spot before readying themselves. Alright. Go Dratini. Reese sent Dratini from its Pokeball. Come on out Clefairy. The lass sent out a Clefairy. Whoa. Where'd you find that? I found it here. I'll tell you where if you beat me in battle. Dot. You're on. Okay then. Clefairy, use the disarming voice. Clefairy shouted and the noise seemed to be very effective against Dratini. Dratini, are you okay? Dratini nodded lightly. Then let's go. Thunder wave. Dratini quickly moved through the air before sending a wave of static at the small fairy type, leaving it paralyzed. Great job. Now use Rat. Dratini wrapped itself around the Clefairy. Clefairy, get it off of you. Clefairy struggled but wasn't able to get Dratini off. Now Dratini. Water pulse. Dratini sent a pulse of water directly at the Clefairy. No. Clefairy. Come on. Use draining kiss. Clefairy readied itself before it hit itself. Clefairy. Whoa. Water pulse confused it. One more time then Dratini. Water pulse. Dratini used water pulse again, as it did before knocking Clefairy out. Aw, well, I guess a loss is a loss. I found Clefairy down a secret ladder in Mount Moon. I wonder if you will find it. Before Reese could ask any more questions, the lass ran off out of the mound. Hey Reese. Angel was heard in the distance. Reese turned to face him. Did you find anything? Apparently there's a secret ladder somewhere in this mound. Dot. Really? I said apparently. Let's just find Cat and Maroon so we can look for it. Okay. A scream that definitely resembled the sound of Cat began to echo through the mound. Reese and Angel looked at each other. Cat. Cat. With Maroon and Cat. Would you shut your mouth toward Ekans? Loudly crying face. Loudly crying face. What about Ekans? Red angry face. I think she's scared of it. She needs to calm down. Cat. Are you okay? Maroon yelled from the distance. More brats. You three again. We're not here for you toward. Yet, we have direct orders from the boss to collect Pokemon fossils from this cave. Don't tell them that. Idiots, both of you person face palming. Shut up me up. Get that Ekans away from me. You don't like Ekans, huh? Get her. Ahhh. Beedrill. Fury attack. Maroon's Beedrill appeared in front of Cat and jabbed Ekans. Sending the snake flying. Ekans. Cat. Where are you? Come on Jesse. Let's get out of here. Yet. We got fossils to find. Fine. The three ran deeper into the mound. Cat, are you okay? Circumflex. Yeah, that weird lady just had a really scary Ekans crying face. Don't worry, they're gone. I have news on Clefairy. Ooh, what is it? We have to find a secret ladder hidden somewhere in the mound. Hey, I wanted to say that. Let's find it then. Cat ran off making all the others and their Pokemon run after her. Until... Cat. The three looked down to see find a hole that Cat had fallen down a ladder. Looks like she found it. Let's go after her. Right. The three and their Pokemon went down the ladder. Bow. Are you okay? Yeah, look. Cat sprang up once she found something pink. Is that? The small pink Pokemon looked up at Cat. It then smiled brightly before walking up to Cat and handing her a moonstone. The trainer has to fit the stone on the Pokemon to evolve it. Jigglypuff and Clefairy began to play around together. Awee. They're so cute. Hey look, what's that over there? They look like rocks. Oh, those are fossils. Fossils? Yeah. I learned all about them at home. You can turn them back into live Pokemon on Cinnabar Island. Whoa, cool. I want one. Me too. Yeah, you two should take them. I already have four Pokemon. Grinning face with smiling eyes and sweat drop. Not so fast. Not again. We'll be taking those fossils. And I'll take that Clefairy. Meowth snatched the Clefairy in a net. Oh no. Cat ran after Meowth. Hey. Reese ran after the two. Guess we'll deal with these two. Yeah. You're so cute. We'll beat you brats easily. The two sent out Ekans and coughing. Maroon sent out Beedrill. Come on Charmander. Ekans use Rap. Coughing use Smog. Ekans jumped towards Beedrill and coughing sent poisonous gas at Charmander. Dodge Charmander, and use Ember. Counter attack with Twineedle. The Ember flew through the gas and hit coughing while the Twineedles hit the Ekans. Coughing. Ekans. Fury attack, go. Dragon breath. Dodge it. Come on coughing. Ekans dodged efficiently, but coughing got hit, 5 times. Ekans. Rat. Ekans jumped at Charmander wrapping itself around it. Charmander. Great job. Tighter now Ekans. Ekans began to wrap itself around Charmander tighter. Come on Charmander. Beedrill, go help Charmander. Tackle coughing. While Beedrill was looking away coughing tackled it. Beedrill. Charmander. Charmander was getting squeezed tighter and tighter. Dragon breath. Charmander looked up and opened its mouth as its tail flame began to grow brighter and larger. Huh? What's happening? Now Beedrill. Pursued. Beedrill used the move against coughing taking its remaining HP. Ekans just wrapped harder. Please Charmander. Dragon breath. Charmander's tail flame grew even larger and its body began to glow white. Gasp. Charmander began to grow and grow before a bright purple and blue began to emerge from its mouth and land directly onto the Ekans. Ekans. Charmander. Dragon rage. Charmander now stood tall. It had evolved. Whoa. I wonder what it evolved into. It evolved. I've got a bad feeling. Angel and Charmeleon both gave the two a deadly gaze. Go. Use Dragon Rage. Wait, where's Meowth? Meowth then flies right next to them. Meowth. What happened, chum? Flashback. Get back here. Yeah. That was a very rude thing to do. Snatching Clefairy like that. Like I care, bud. Oh. I'll make you care. Go Rapidash. Minutails. Cat threw two Pokeballs into the air, from them came out a very icy Minutails and a pink and purple Rapidash. Whoa. Resamed the Pokédex's camera at the two Pokémon. Rapidash, Galarian form, the unique horn Pokémon. Brave and prideful, this Pokémon dashes airily through the forest, its steps aided by the psychic power stored in the fur on its fetlocks. Minutails, Alolan form, the fox Pokémon, while it will guide travelers who get lost on a snowy mountain down to the mountain's base, it won't forgive anyone who harms nature. They seem pretty strong. Moonblast. Let's go. Both Minutails and Rapidash sent Moonblasts directly at the Meowth. Gah. Alright. Squirtle Rapid Spin. Squirtle rammed itself into Meowth making it drop the Clefairy. Ice Beam. Psycho Cut. Pikachu. Thundershot. Ah. Calm down bud. The three combined attacks landed and sent Meowth flying. Yes they broke holes through Mount. Moon relieved face. Looks like that problem solved. Clefairy. Reese looked down to see the Clefairy holding a Moonstone up to him. For me? The Clefairy nodded. Thanks. Cat returned Minutails and Rapidash. Thanks for the help Reese. Of course. Not like you needed any though. You'll definitely be a great gym leader. Aw, thanks. Cat looked down to the Clefairy. So, can I catch you now? Smiling face. Clefairy agreed happily and Cat touched it with the Pokeball. Let's get back to Maroon and Angel. Yet, the four met back up. Hey, did you guys get Clefairy? Yeah, cool. Angel? Who's that? Guys, this is Charmander. What? It evolved. Into what though? Here. Reese aimed the Pokédex's camera at the newly evolved Charmander. Charmeleon, the flame Pokémon, tough fights could excite this Pokémon. When excited, it may blow out bluish-white flames. Cool. Wow. Charmeleon looked up, basking in the praise it was getting. Well then. So, this is where we split off? No. I think I'll accompany you guys for a little longer. I have an old friend in Cerulean I'd like to visit before I go home. Okay. It's settled then. To Cerulean City. Let's go. Yeah. And so, our heroes have finally helped Cat find her Clefairy, they even managed to obtain fossils and Angel evolved his Charmander. Who is Cat's old friend and what will our heroes do in Cerulean City? Only time will tell as the journey continues.